Marcel Beugelsdijk from the Netherlands, owner of Bemint and specialized in Power Query. This video is about using Power Query to parse multidimensional JSON input. The reason for this video was this question on the Power BI community forum. I copied the input into Power Query JSON data, so this file also works without external input. I will share the PBIX file below the video. And the output from this query is exactly the same as if I would have imported the file using JSON data, as I will demonstrate. JSON, and the file is over here. So if that is imported, then the result is exactly the same as from this query. So I remove this query again and proceed with this input. I created this description and explanation how to parse multidimensional JSON. And I will follow along this approach, and I will share this document also in the link below the video. First step, as a preparation, disable automatic detection of relationships. That is over here in the options and settings. The current file data load. There is an option to auto detect new relationships after data is loaded. That option should be unchecked. Otherwise, relationships would be created that we don't want. So I uncheck this option. Next, import of a JSON file Power Query results in a record. This record is converted to a table. So we have to convert this to a table. I won't adjust that query, but I will reference that query. I will do that lots of times when parsing JSON data. So start with some intermediate results and proceed from there until the data model is complete. So this has to be a table. There is a button into table. And then we need to transpose because we want data in columns. Use first row as header. And now there's a change type step automatically added when I promoted the headers. Basically, it's okay to have all data typed. But a drawback of this way of typing data is that all columns are explicitly referenced. So there won't be any flexibility when the data structure might change in the data. So I will as much as possible avoid that columns are hard-coded and referenced in the query. So instead of this table transform column types, I will use a custom function table convert column types. This function was created by Colin Benfield. And I provide a lot of participation in this topic on the TechNet forum. I will include the link also below the video. So back to this query. Instead of table transform column types, we want table convert column types. So I will use this code as basis. Saves me a lot of typing. Table convert to column types, and this function only requires the name of the table, which is the name of the previous step, promoted headers. So now we have a correctly typed table. The column events cannot be typed, it has type any because these consist of a nested list. So let's go back to the document. We are now, let's say, at a staging query 1, and it states if a table has columns with nested values, lists of records. Well, there are lists of records over here, so that is the case. That are not empty, they are not empty as we saw. Then it becomes a staging query with a load disabled. I already created some groups. You can create a group by right-click and check move to group. It is already in the correct group staging queries, but if you require a new group, then you can create one by choosing this option. But I already created the groups. So I will leave it in this group, but I will rename it because this table is apparently about statuses. So I will call it status staging. I will call each query staging if it is an intermediate result. So it has nested tables, it is an intermediate result. So that is what I done. Point B, a table is created without a nested values. So that will be the status table. Again, right click reference status staging. Rename the new query to status without the nested data. Right click remove. And I can move it to tables. And there we have our first table, which will be part of the data model. Back to the schedule. A function is created to drill down into the columns with nested values. Basically, what we have to do is to drill down into this column and make a new query for the events data. I created this function, which will create a function specifically for one table to drill down into the column with nested values. The reason why I created a function that creates a function is because of the following. In general, if you want to create a function in which you can input a table column, then you would create a function like this, new query table column as list, and the output is hello. So now we have a function, and in the user interface you have now a button to choose a column. So we have the table status staging, and if I select this table, then I only get two columns. So a normal function with a list as a parameter will give you a choice of table columns except the nested values, and that is exactly what we require. So that's why I created a function, this function, that will create a function to drill down into status staging. So I will select this table. You can also provide a culture code, because in the function that is created, the data will be typed, and with data typing it is possible to provide a culture code, but it is an optional field. You might provide something like English US, and then all data will be converted using culture code English US, but you can leave it blank and then your current culture code will be used. So you only need to provide a table, invoke, then a new function is created, and now there is a list of all the column names from which we can choose, including events. So that's why a separate function was created that creates a function for each staging query with nested values. I will delete this one now. It was only to demonstrate how it works. And I will call this function and drill down status staging. I move it to the group functions. You can just drag and move a query to another group. And now I choose the events column. Basically what this function will do, it will take the events column and drill down into this column and create a new table from that, as we will see. So I choose the events column, invoke, and now we have our table. So basically, if we go back to the general steps, we created a table table 2 from the nested values in query 1. But in point 1 it states if a table has a column with nested values, list of records that are not empty, then it becomes a staging query. Now we see columns with nested lists and these are not empty. This is empty, but there are not empty records. So this will also be a staging query. It was about events, so I call this events staging. I will right click disable load and move it to status staging. So back to this. We were with status staging a table created without a nested values. We done that. A function is created to drill down into the columns with nested values. Yes, I use that. Using function C, tables are created from each column with nested values. So that is what I did in events staging. I will show what is being done in this function, advanced editor. The first part and the last part are to create a function. And the inner part is what is actually done by that function. So make list creates a list of all items in the column. I will explain by looking at events staging. There's also a column with nested records, but these are records and not lists of records. So the step make lists in this function will create lists of records from single records. Then the list column is expanded. Then all records, if there are null values, then these are replaced by empty records. Next, two tables is used to expand the individual records on the individual rows. The two table step will combine all those tables from all those rows into one table. And then important also, if you would drill down manually into a column with nested values, then make sure you remove a blank rows, because there can be blank rows, as there might not be a value for the nested list on each row. There might be duplicates that must be removed, and the data should be properly typed. And notice that in this function, the same table convert column types function is used as we already saw earlier. So this function requires this function. You cannot use this function without this function. Okay, back to the general steps. We are at E for status staging. If a table has multiple columns with nested values, a staging bridges query is created. Well, the status table, status staging, has only one column with nested values. So we won't do that. We can skip step E, skip F. From the staging query, A or E, so that is A in our case, bridge tables are created for each table D with key values from table B and table D. So we have this table status and we are going to create this bridge table from the ID column over here and the nested value over here, as I will demonstrate. Again, reference status staging, reference. Select the ID columns and right-click remove other columns. Drill down into the events and then we only need the events IDs. So we select only the ID field and we make sure that use original column name as prefix is checked. Okay. Now this column will be typed to a whole number. Again, the column name is now hard coded, but for key columns, the column names will be hard coded anyhow. So there's no need to avoid that. And we can just use the menu option to change the type into a whole number, as I just did. And I will also rename this column to status.id, because this is now the bridge table that points to the status ID and the events ID. Important when creating a bridge table that you always check remove empty. Even if the table has no empty values, it might get some empty values with new data, and then you would have null values as key values in a bridge table, and that might cause issues. So you make sure that you filter out nulls in the events.id column. In this case, status ID will always have a value. So this will be the bridge table between status and events. It is a table that will be part of the data model. So I move it to tables. In the schedule, so we have a staging query, status staging. We created a status table with the IDs and the other columns. We created a bridge table with the ID and the ID for table 2, which is the events table. And that is where we are. So the next step is to proceed with events staging, which is staging query 2. And we go back to step 1. Ah, that was point G for each table D. So that's the events staging query. The process repeats at step 1. If a table has columns with nested values that are not empty, it becomes a staging query with load disabled. We already did that, so that's the events staging. A table is created without the nested values. That will be the events table. So right-click reference. Rename it in events. And the columns with nested values will be removed. So that are these columns. Shift-click, Control-click. Right-click, remove columns. And now we have the table without the nested values. So that's the events table. Next, a function is created to drill down into the columns with nested values. Again, using this function for events staging. Invoke, rename, drill down events staging. I move this query over here. So that's what we did. Point D, using function C, tables are created from each columns with nested values. And now it will go fast because we have four columns with nested values. That are the services, resources, contacts and additional data column. So for those four tables, I will create tables. Column name, services, invoke, rename to services. Let's check this table if it has nested values. It has a nested list, but it is empty. So we won't create a staging query. As mentioned, the nested values that are not empty. So what I will do for now is expand to new rows. I have just a null value. This point indicates that it is important to have the representative data in your input when starting to create queries. If you have only a small sample that doesn't reflect the actual data structure of your production data, then the resulting queries might be insufficient to parse the JSON data from your production table. So I will do this like this right now. So we have a services table. We can move over here. Next, drill down the resources table, invoke, rename F2 resources. There are no nested values over there, so we can move it over here. And we have new table. Drill down, event staging, next column are the contacts. Invoke. Contacts. Check for nested values. Again, there is an empty list, so I will expand to new rows, and again the remark to have representative data available before you start parsing JSON data. Move it over here. And last but not least, the additional data column, invoke the function rename additional data. Move it to the tables. Back to the schedule, we are at E. If a table has multiple columns with nested values, so that was for events staging, it has multiple columns with nested values, so yes. A staging bridges query is created with the ID columns and all columns with nested values. So I will reference this query, right click reference, rename. Events bridges staging, disable load because it is a staging query, click, control click, control click, control click, control click, right click, remove other columns. Yeah, there it is. And the reason why another staging query is required for the bridges is simply because I want to rename this to events.id because this field will point to the events table. So that was point E. And then we are going to create a bridge tables for each table in D. We created four tables: services, resources, contacts, and additional data. So now we have to create the bridge tables between events and services and resources and contacts and additional data. So right click reference. The first one, services. Remove other columns. Expand to new rows. Expand. Whole number, and don't forget to remove empties. There was an empty now, so that's obvious, but it should be done always. Rename this to events services. Move it over here. That will be most easy when we start creating relationships. So the next is the resources bridge table. Right click reference. Select events ID and resources, right click, remove other columns, expand to new rows, expand, select all columns, don't select all columns, but only select the ID and use original column name as prefix, okay, whole number, and remove empties, must always be included in your query. This one is events resources, bridge table. Next, right click reference, events, control click context, right click, remove other columns, expand to new rows, expand only the ID with original column name, whole number, remove empty, and this is events context. Over here, and we need events additional data, events bridges staging, right click a reference, events ID, control click additional data, right click remove other columns, expand, okay, there were only records, so there's only one expansion, cancel whole number, and remove empties. So this is the bridge between events and additional data. So now we have all our tables. Maybe a short recap is first, we created staging query 1, status staging. From there, we created table status and the bridge table status events. Table 2 is events with ID and the attributes. And there is a bridge table, or actually 4 bridge tables between events and all the tables from the nested values over here. So these were the steps. Next, all tables without nested values and bridge tables make up the tables in the data model. Relationships are created between the tables and their corresponding bridge tables. These are many-to-one relations with the bridge table at the many side and the table at the one side. So, close and apply. To apply the query changes. And we can go to the relationships. And we can just drag and drop. So the I will do it like this. The status ID goes over here. I will first drag and drop all the relationships. So the events will be in the center. That is quite clear. Events services will be between events and services. I will decrease the size of the table. So I will just drag the bridge table with the corresponding table, bridge table with the contacts and the additional data. With additional data. So this is a nice star model, events ID, resources ID, events ID. You can just drag this over there, context ID, and additional data, events ID, additional data ID. Now choose manage relationships and check all the relationships one by one. So edit the first one. The bridge table is on top, so that is the many side, many to one. Cross filter direction, both. I will just keep that as a standard. So this way you have to check all the relationships. The second one, edit. The many is on the top, events on the bottom, direction both. And the last is the bridge table is on top, many to one, yes, and both directions. Okay, close. And here is the data model. So we are done. I will save this file and provide a link below the video. I will also provide a link to this document with all the steps that were applied. I didn't cover a special note. It might be that if tables are created, that during the process it appears that a table is referenced multiple times, because it is a dimension table that is related to multiple other tables. In that case, there will be multiple versions of the same table, and that has to be combined at the end. And then the individual tables will be staging queries, and only the combined table will then be the dimension table. But that is not the case over here, but it should be noted for even more complex JSON structures that that may be the case. So I hope it is all clear. I will share the links to the PBIX file, to this document, and to this topic in the TechNet forum about creating the functions for dynamically transforming column types via Power Query. Thanks for watching. See you again in another video about Power Query.